There's a new tool inside of Lightroom Classic and Camera Raw that enables you to automatically blur the background. I'm going to give you an in-depth look to this, but we're also going to look at how to precisely refine that blur and get it absolutely perfect. We're going to use the new lens blur in the Develop module of Lightroom Classic. Now, this same tool is also in Camera Raw and it works identical. So the first thing we want to do is apply the blur. So to do that, choose Apply, and now the AI is going to analyze the image. It's going to find the subject, which is the horse and the cowboy, and blurs the background. Now, there's a number of features, and we're going to look at them all now. One of the things we're going to do is refine this blur so that the lasso is also sharp. But first of all, let's look at the settings. The blur amount. If we increase it, we can have a very heavy blur. If we decrease it, it's more subtle. I'm just going to double click to reset the default, which is 50, and we'll adjust it later. Generally, less blur looks a little more realistic. Now, we have the ability to set different types of bokehs. I'll give you another example after this with some light so I can show you how that works. So we'll just close that out. All right, the next thing we want to look at is focal range. You'll notice that this little picture of a head is selected by default. That automatically detects the subject and blurs the background, but we can change it. If we grab the target, we can change the area that will be sharp. If we click in the background, now the background will be the area in focus and everything else will be out of focus. I could hit this pillar or the door behind it. Or if I want to go back to the subject, we just choose the subject and it will automatically select it. If it doesn't get what you want, just use the target tool and just click on the subject. And if you're getting any value out of this video, hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my videos. So obviously there's a little bit more depth to this image, and that's what this graph shows. The little blocks there are showing pixels. If we look on the left, this is the foreground or close to the camera. If we go to the right side, that's far away from the camera. And we can look at the depth map by choosing Visualize Depth. The depth map marks the image. The lighter the areas they are, the closer they are to us. The darker they are, the further away it is. And this is a tool that we'll use in a second to refine this blur selection. But first of all, I'm going to turn Visualize Depth off for a moment. And I'm going to show you this slider. If we drag this slider, we can change the area of focus, just like doing a rack focus, as if we're focusing on the camera. There's a second function. We can make the depth of field very shallow, meaning that only a very small area is in focus by dragging these closer together. And this would closely resemble something more like a prime lens at an f1.8 or an f1.4. And we can drag it, and now a very, very narrow area is in focus at a time. If we want to have a deeper depth of field or more of the area in focus, we just make this box longer. And see, that box covers a larger area of distance now, therefore keeping a larger area in focus. In fact, if I drag it all the way across, everything's in focus. As I pull it here, notice the background is not in focus as much over here. So this is a nice way to change this and get a certain amount of realism. Right now, I feel like we need to refine this. If I click on the subject, it will reset that. So let's just extend it a little bit more. And I could just drag this out if I wanted, right there. And this is one way I could fix the issue with the lasso not being selected. In fact, if I hide it, we can see before and after. All that's happening is over here on the left is getting a little bit blurry. So it's only affecting the extreme background. But what if I want to have a shallower depth of field and refine this? Well, let's do that. Let's bring it in a little bit shallower, maybe about here. And notice we have some problems. Let's fix them. I notice a couple of problems here. We've got a little problem with his hat with the lasso here, but also a little bit more there. So this is where visualizing depth can really help us. If we turn this on, we can easily see what we're working with. And now I want to refine it. So I'm going to choose refine. And now we have the ability to choose the focus or the blur. So I'm going to choose focus because we need this part of the lasso to be closer. So I'm just going to make sure auto mask is turned on. And we can paint in here. And let's see if we can get it pretty good. All right, I've gone over a little bit. That doesn't matter, but let's get the rest of this. So I'm just painting these areas. Okay, so if you look at this, this is a little bit more orange, meaning it's further back. Now we can adjust this by using the amount. As we adjust this amount, notice it goes further back or further forward. See how it gets darker or lighter? So we can adjust this. And if I turn off the visualized depth, you'll be able to see what's happening. See what happens as I adjust it? I want to match what's in the picture. So we want that forward. Now, we might need to clean that up a little bit. So we're going to choose the blur. And with the blur selected, we can go in here and we can clean this up. And let's look at the visualized depth to see what's going on. I'm going to go really small here and I want to add a little bit of blur to the background between the rope. And that auto mask helps me do this. Now let's change the amount of the blur to match the background. See what happens? Now it starts to match. And then when we turn off visualized depth, it's starting to look pretty good. So notice this area here. This also needs to be blurred, but it's closer to the camera than the area behind there. So we need a different amount of blur. So what we can do is hit the plus. And now when we hit the plus, we can add a new area and apply our own amount of blur to it. So let's just go in here and select that. Once again, let's choose visualize depth so we can see what's going on better. And if I look at this, it's a little too dark. So we're going to take the amount slider and we're going to slide it over a little bit till it matches the rest of the background. Now this is going to give us a nice refinement. So if I turn visualize depth off, and if you look at that, it matches beautifully now. So what we want to do is turn off these refine tools. So all we need to do is just click on blur and notice it gets turned off. And now I can click with the hand tool to zoom back out. But it's still blurred too much. So what we're going to do is reduce the blur amount, put it to something that's a little bit more believable, put a little bit more of this in focus to be more realistic, adjust the blur amount, and I think we've got a pretty realistic background blur. All right, let's have a look at the bokeh. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to choose apply so we can get a blur here. And we're going to blur it all the way up. And so what we want to do is we want to have this light in focus and these lights out of focus. Let's make a much shallower depth of field. So we're just focusing in on there. And those other lights now are kind of thrown off. So why don't we boost it a little bit so you can see what's going on. Now this here is an example right there or up there, also on the lights themselves, but these little rings are going to give a better example. So what the bokeh does is it simulates different types of apertures so it looks like we're using different types of cameras to blur the background. And this is a circular. This is what most modern cameras do. The second option is a bubble with an overcorrected spherical aberration. The third option, the five blade gives a pentagon shape and this simulates a vintage camera. This is a ring and this is common on a single lens reflex camera or an SLR or film cameras. And then we have a cat eye effect. Now typically we would turn this boost down a little bit for a more realistic result. So let me know in the comments underneath if you learned anything new in this video. And if you want to know more about the new features inside of Lightroom Classic, check out my other video here. If you're new, hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications, and you won't miss any of my tutorials. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.